arrived in the Bahamas, we had to check in with Customs and Immigration to get our visas, which included a cruising permit and fishing licenses. Once we were cleared, we could replace our yellow quarantine flag with the Bahamian courtesy flag. We anchored in Nixon's Harbor in South Bimini and had the place almost to ourselves, surrounded by 6 to 10 feet of clear water.
We could jump into it right off the boat.
That used to be a beach club and marina right on the tip of the island there, but apparently it closed a year or two ago. All the structure is still there, and it could be a protected dock for us if the winds pick up. We could tuck in there. And it's free since no one's there. What a find!
Sorry for the wind. This is Peacemaker's second home in South Bimini. We gave up our anchorage because of some very heavy winds, 30-35 knots, and came to this amazing abandoned marina, the Beach Sands Beach Club in South Bimini, who knows? It is gorgeous. Just a nice 360 here. Pristine sand, nobody's here. And there's Peacemaker all by herself, tied up, very snug as a boat in a marina. Just a lot of cool wildlife or sea life in there. Fish, jack, jellyfish, spiny lobster. Bro, stop eating that.
We found that one of the biggest challenges of living on a boat is conserving our fresh water. We were surprised by how much water we'd been used to using once we became aware of it every time we turned on the faucet. To fill our water tanks in the Bahamas, we pay by the gallon. So when we find water for free, like a random faucet at this abandoned marina, we took advantage of it for rinsing off and cleaning equipment.
Got my water filled up from the faucet. And I'll just give you a 360 view here. This is quite the hidden gem. It's the pool area. The old bar is boarded up. The restaurant. Weirdly, the bathroom still works. It's over there. Got the beach view. The bar behind me. Coconut trees, mangrove, marina. All once. Really breathtaking now. Something else that's been forgotten. Yeah, because we're kind of squatting in the marina right now, we don't feel bad, but we feel obliged to pick up some of the trash on the beach. And around here in Bimini, there's a lot of it. So we've been using a trash jeep right here as our receptacle. We don't have a better solution except to put it in the back here. There's no dumpsters around anywhere. Hopefully when somebody picks up the marina, buys it, they'll clean it up and take trash jeep with it. It's not a great solution, but it's the solution we've come up with. So, hashtag trash project, pick up your trash. Enjoying some fresh coconuts here in South Bimini. All these trees are very giving, and a lot of beautiful young coconuts out here. This isn't for the faint of heart, but all the way up there, I climbed to get one. That's like 7-8 feet. Days when the winds die down and head south for some more diving.
Hey Josh, where are we heading?
To the beach! We're headed to Atlantis, the city under the sea. The alleged city under the sea. but the real one. Apparently there's a road under the water that nobody knows how it got there. It's about 12 feet of water, and we're gonna go look at it.
We dove there, but since no one has actually ever found the lost city of Atlantis, we moved on. Okay, so here we are at a wreck, a dive site and a great fishing site called Sapona. It's right near Turtle Rock and just south of South Bimini where we had been anchored. So today is a beautiful day. We decided to set off to our next anchorage, and Sapona was on the way.
The water was full of these small thimble jellyfish, migrating somewhere, I guess. They stung a little only if you touched them just right, but their eggs could leave a rash for a few days if you stay in your swimsuit after being in the water. Sapona looked too cool to skip though, so we jumped in with the jellyfish and just showered and changed right after the dive. Sapona was a cargo steamship that ran aground during a hurricane in 1926. All these years has given a reef plenty of time to develop, so it has interesting coral and a ton of sea life. On our swim back to Peacemaker, Josh even found a conch that we cooked up for dinner.
Hi! We're in Honeymoon Harbor, even though we're not on our honeymoon. Now we're scanning across the Great Bahama Bay, which is a huge flat of shallows in the middle of the Bahamas that we're actually going to be crossing tomorrow.
Honeymoon Harbor had a lot of friendly southern stingrays. We heard that people had been feeding them, which is why they swam right up to us, expecting food. Surprisingly, Brew didn't even seem to notice them. She's been practicing her swimming though, and getting much better. She's so dedicated, she even practices out of the water. I just can't get over how incredible the water is, and I wanted to get a different perspective. Plus, I've been meaning to take a look at our standing rigging anyway, so Josh hoisted me up our mast, more than 50 feet up. There was only a light breeze, but the mast swayed with even the slightest wave, so I was clinging on for dear life to steady myself. And of course, I was harnessed in the bosun chair. The views were absolutely spectacular. Oh, yeah. Man, I want you to know that. Oh.
there's Josh, way down there. Thanks for watching. We'd love to stay connected. Visit awildwaypoint.com or follow us on Facebook.